How many of you are from the class 12th here? Is anyone? Okay. Oh, most of you. And the others are from 11th? Okay. How many of you have heard of the university? The name of the university? Has anybody heard of Krea? No? Has anybody heard of a university? You have? Okay. Thank God there's one student. Anyways, it's not your fault because it's just a one-year-old university. Okay, we are very new. So it's fine. Has anybody heard of a university called Shivnadar? Yes? Okay, Opi Jindal? Azim Premji? So let me tell you this, that today, you know, really, at this time, it's the most exciting time to be studying in higher education in India. Because when I studied, when we all studied, there were either the IITs, where you had to lock yourself into a room for 3-4 years and prepare to get into an IIT. But in the private education space, in higher education, there weren't too many universities. You had to go abroad. Yeah. Today in India, you have universities that will provide you the same kind of intellectual environment, the same freedom to choose courses between sciences, humanities, and the arts, and the same quality of faculty that you would get at a good global university at 1/6 of the cost. Okay? And many of the universities, like I mentioned, at least some of them, Krea definitely is financially inclusive, which means that you don't have to worry whether you can afford the fees or not. Yeah? How does that work? Is that you have to get selected. That is a difficult part. But if you do get selected, then we have 100% aid available if you can't afford the fees. We have almost 25% of our students who study free of cost. So when you're applying, don't think whether you can afford or not. Okay? I'll come to that a little later. Can anybody tell me what this is? The timeline of what? Take a guess. Do you see? Okay, that's a timeline. 1850, 1900, 1950, 2000. What can this be? What is this number? Year? Okay, and what does it show? The Earth's temperature. Can you see how it's moving? Do you see all those red lines? Is it scary? So, I don't know if you, how many of you like to read, by the way, read, write, apart from your class books? Okay. So, you know, just a tip is that all of you who raised your hands have a better chance of getting into a good university. Because every good university is looking at students who can form opinions, who can talk, who have ability to comprehend multiple things, connect the dots. Yeah? Am I making sense? Okay. So, I don't know how many of you read this, but Sundarbans is in West Bengal, right? So because of the cyclone Bulbul that came, Sundarbans is sinking every year. And because of the cyclone, it's sinking much faster than we anticipated. Odisha is losing kilometers of coastline every year because of climate change. Yeah. So, you know, people like me or before me didn't care really about it. Climate, right? But unfortunately, you all, sorry, but you all are in a position where you have to care. By 2025, the World Economic Forum says that 20 Indian cities will run out of drinking water. And 2025 is not 50 years after now. It's just 5-6 years. So, why am I telling you all this? Let me also show you another slide. How many of you have heard of something called a fourth industrial revolution? 1, 2, 3. What do you know about it? Anything unique? Okay. So, all of you know about the history of industrial revolutions? So, first one was when steam engines were invented. Second was when we started factory line manufacturing, large companies. Third was when there was digital age or internet. The fourth one, again, the world. So, how many of you want to study economics or business? No one? Okay. Some of you? So, whoever wants to study the social sciences, there is a company or there's an organization called the World Economic Forum. Okay, you must follow it. They have a lot of things that come up every now and then. They make beautiful videos of what's happening around the world. You should be aware. Okay, so again, so the World Economic Forum says that the fourth industrial revolution is going to be much different from everything else that happened before. So the lines between what is physical, what is digital, and what is biological are blurring. You look at technologies. Have you heard of Internet of Things? Yeah, IoT. Has anybody heard of Alexa, the voice recognition? Yeah, or Face ID? Now, tell me one thing. Somebody who developed the Face ID on an Apple phone, was there a biologist involved while inventing Face ID? Was there a computer scientist involved? Yes. Was there a psychologist involved? Was there a behavioral scientist involved? Was there a lawyer involved? All of them were. So today's problems are like this, where you can't supposed to just study one thing and say that it's enough for me. You always have an option. Like, for example, you can go to Kolkata University. You can study, you know, BA in psychology or BA in arts or B.Sc. in biology. But for those 3 years, you're only studying that one subject. And many of the times in traditional universities, the curriculum is not changed. Today, if you want to study chemistry, at an undergrad level, I'm saying, it should be affected by the climate change around the world. If it doesn't, then there is a problem. Anything that you want to do, how many of you, okay, let's do this also. How many of you are sure of what you want to study after class 12th? 100% sure that I have no confusion. What are some of the things? Can you all tell me? Stats? Math? Doctor? MBBS? Many doctors here, okay. Yes, you? Design? Law? Anyone else? Anything else? Any of you? No? Not sure? So, you know, it's okay to be not sure. Today, I'm 29. I have changed 4 jobs in 3 different industries. I've studied computer science, I've studied design, I've studied branding. And this is going to be the lives of many of you, where you start thinking that this is something that I want to do with my life. But in an instant, somebody else will come tomorrow, will give you a brilliant talk about social sciences, and you'll all believe that I want to do social sciences or psychology. We are very volatile, right? That way we'll watch a movie and then think that this is what I want to do. And sometimes it's okay. It's okay to be confused, especially if you're planning to study something called liberal arts and sciences, okay? Now, if you read any of those reports by the World Economic Forum, by Cognizant, or by any of those companies, all of them say that these are the skills that will be required. All of you have heard of automation, right? AI, has anybody heard of artificial intelligence? Who wants to study computers here? Anyone? Okay, some of you. You must have heard about AI and automation and how it's taking away jobs. So somebody said law, right? You know how highly law is being automated now? IBM Watson, yeah? In fact, there's a company called BNP Paribas. It's one of the biggest law firms in the world, right? 80% of their employees are being shown red slips. This is an age of disruption. So whatever course you want to study, whether it is law, whether it is medicine, whether it's design, whether it is economics, whether it's business, you have to make sure that whatever course you're studying has to have one of this. If it doesn't, then there is a problem. Because, see, courses like, I don't know how many, if anybody is interested in courses like accountancy or becoming an accountant, you know, that read about this. It's not me who's saying this, but those are the highest risk jobs. Anything that is A plus B equal to C, you don't need humans to do. Machines will do it much faster. They don't want holidays, no salary hikes, no getting tired, no making mistakes. So anything that is very clerical has the highest chance of getting automated. We as humans, going forward, will have to get into jobs that make us think, that requires creativity, that requires emotional intelligence. That is why, you know, professions like teaching, or for example, counselling, anything that is to do with humans, doctors, very high, when you know the automation chances in those are the least, because human beings behave differently, right? So think of what jobs you want to do. Emotional intelligence, right? So much of our lives are going to be governed by automation. You know, when you go on Amazon today and buy something, it'll show you, right? People who bought this also bought this. They're studying patterns. Google today knows everything about you, all your dark secrets. They know what colors you like. They know where you order your food from. They know which road you take from school to home, from school to your tuitions. They know everything about you, what time you sleep. Yeah? Where do you buy your clothes from? So, you know, the amount of information they have on you, it's really scary. And the future world is going to be more and more automated. You will get so customized. You know, like today, if you go to Times Square in New York, in that whole square, Apple has been able to find out the 3 minutes in the day when the most high net worth people are walking across Times Square. And that 3 minutes, you only see Apple ads everywhere. Like if you walk into a Costa cafe, you'll get a message from Starbucks saying, hey, you know what, we have 40% discount for you. And we're just 200 meters away. That's the level of marketing and customization that is happening with data. How many of you want to study data? Data science? One of the most upcoming fields that there is. Yeah. So find out about these new age careers. And there are so many like that. And all of you, all of us, you know, think that the traditional jobs are more safe, right? Do you know what is the average salary of an engineer in India today? 4,000 rupees. After studying 4 years of engineering, the average salary is 4,000. After doing an MBBS, you have almost 60% chances of not getting a job. After studying 5 years of medicine, you have to do masters. Otherwise, you don't get jobs at good hospitals. Yeah? So traditional careers that you always thought were very safe aren't so safe anymore. Yeah, so really think, you know, you all have a choice. You can also be like the 10 lakh other students in India who finish till class 12th, get their scores, and then decide what university to go to. Or you can start now. Start looking at university. Because I'm saying that there are so many good universities in India. Yeah? You have to put in a little effort. You know, there's no victory without hard work, right? Now, coming to Krea, right? So, Krea University started by... there were already, as I said, many good universities. But a lot of people, enthusiastically, people from the industry, people from academia, people like Dr. Raghuram Rajan, Anand Mahindra. Who's Kiran Mazumdar Shaw? Anybody's heard of her? Anybody wants to do life sciences here? So you must have heard of a company called Biocon. It's one of the biggest life sciences company. She's the founder of the company. Yeah, you have people like T.M. Krishna, a musician. I don't know if anybody's heard of T.M. Krishna. We have an academic council which is equally illustrious. Somebody said math, right? Do you know of something called a Fields Medal in math? So Fields Medal is actually the highest honor that you can get as a mathematician. It's more difficult to get than a Nobel Prize. Because Nobel you get every year. Fields Medal you get once in 4 years. And there's an upper limit of 40, the age. So we have somebody called Professor Manjul Bhargava, who's a Fields Medal winner from Princeton on our council. We have people like Professor John Echemandi. He's the longest serving provost of Stanford University. We have Vishakha Desai, who's an advisor on international relations to Colombia. We have Srinath Raghavan, who's a policy advisor to the government of India. So people like that, of those caliber from around the world, have come together to start Krea University. Okay? Which means that whatever's taught at the university, even if they're regular courses like economics, the curriculum is really thought after to make sure that when you graduate, you're not just able to work in the banking and financial industry, but really in any industry. Because again, according to the same report by World Economic Forum, it says anybody who graduates after 2025 will change 7 careers, 7 industries, and more than 20 jobs. So how, as students sitting here, you decide of what course should I study? Or as a university, what do we teach? Yeah? Something to think about. We are also a fully philanthropic university. Do you know what is philanthropic? Yeah, so money that has come into the university, it's not a real estate company that's putting money. It's not a corporation. It is a group of people who've donated money to start. the university. So in the first phase, we've raised about 800 crores. And we will continue to raise more funds, but the university will never have any founder, it will never have any one family or one company that's governing the university. Okay? What do we offer, the programs? We offer a BA honors and a B.Sc. honors degree. So it's a three-year undergraduate program. The fourth year is a year of advanced studies, which is optional for you. So you can decide to study in case you want to do more research or deep dive into your own major. It's for the fourth year. Okay? But otherwise, it's a three-year degree. So, you know, when I was saying that how do you prepare as students for the future, I think we've come up with a model of interwoven learning. This is a little high level, you know, pardon me if I don't spend too much time on this. But really, we've identified what are the skills that will be required by everyone, regardless of you becoming a doctor or a lawyer or a scientist or an artist or a writer or a journalist. What are the skills that will be required? So we've come up with 8 guiding principles. So things like communication skills, right? Do you think communication is important? So anybody who said computer science who want to study, Google is probably one of the best companies to work for, right, in technology. So Google did a research in their own staff to find out who were the best performers inside of Google. So it was not people who had the best technical skills, it was people who could communicate well. Because computer scientists just can't talk. They don't know how to communicate about their projects, ask for help, and work in a collaborative environment. So communication is key. So at Krea, if you do journalism or you do biology, you will have a very strong writing program. How do you communicate with everyone, right? Things like data science. So they are not related to computers because data is part of all of our lives. All our arguments today are based on data, right? We say, you know, 60% of people did this. That's why it's true. So even if you want to study history, there will be a course of data. Ethics, you know, nobody today is talking about ethical decisions. But at the university, at whatever level you study, there will be courses in ethics that will help you make those right decisions. So this is something that we are different from most of the universities in the world. How does the course work? In 3 years, so it's a little different from if you go, for example, to Xavier's College, where you know, if you go and you study economics, from the first year onwards, you start studying economics, right? There's nothing. In Krea or in any liberal university, do you understand what is liberal? So many of you might have heard of the term liberal arts, right? So liberal arts is a wrong perception about it, that it is just for humanities and, you know, art students, but it's not. Liberal education is the way you study. Like, what board are you studying here? CBSE? So the difference between CBSE and, say, for example, an IB board, right? CBSE, you have science students or humanities students or arts students, right? You really can't take subjects like biology and literature together, can you? So the board is a little restrictive. Whereas if you go to international boards, you can study environment along with chemistry, along with, you know, psychology. Those combinations are possible. Liberal arts is just that. That after you finish your 12th, why should you give up on subjects? Because many of you might have multiple interests, right? You might like psychology and you might like biology. You like politics and you like economics. Why should you give up on anything? So in liberal education, you can study multiple subjects together and create a beautiful degree for yourself, okay? So when you come into a liberal university, the first year is called a foundation year. And that foundation year is common for everyone, whether you want to study sciences or humanities or social sciences or arts. Okay. What are the subjects that you have? So these are about 11 subjects that you study in the first year. So regardless of you coming from humanities background, there will be a course in mathematical reasoning. Again, because you just can't run away from numbers, right? But this math is very different from the math that you have in school. Yeah. You will have courses like scientific reasoning. How do you reason, right? You will have courses like creative expression. So even if you're coming from the sciences, you have to do creative expression, which will have media and photography and all of those inside of the course. You have to do philosophy. You have to do computer science because, again, technology is important. Yeah. So once, And this also you should consider as an exploratory year. That 1 year you're studying all common courses, that gives you more time to decide on what exactly do you want to study in your undergrad. And these are the majors that we offer at Krea. Under the BA honors, we offer economics, history, literature, political science, social studies, and the arts. In arts, we have music, theater, performing arts, art journalism, art writing. And then we have B.Sc, which is sciences. You have computers, biology, environmental studies, math, physics, chemistry, and psychology. Okay? So now, as I said, you can take any of these as a major and any of these as a minor. Like, students can study psychology and music and get into music therapy. Students can study computers and math together and go into data science and deep learning and artificial intelligence. You can study economics and computer science and get into financial technology. So you really decide. You can study physics and, no, you can study biology and IT computers and get into biotechnology. So you really decide on what is that you want to study. Okay? All of those are available. The only two subjects that we offer just as minors is business studies and philosophy. Okay. More about these, you can go on the website and find out. How many Indian universities rank in the top 100 in the world? Sorry? I said, how many Indian universities rank in the top 100? Five? Take a guess. Five or six? In the zero? Okay. Top 200? Zero? Zero? Top 300? There were universities from India which were in the top 200, but now, even in the top 300, none of our universities rank. Indian Institute of Science was one of the universities. There was IIT Bombay and Delhi, which featured in top 200. But now, they are also above top 300, right? The biggest reason, again, is research. As a country, first of all, we don't get too many grants in research. Though IITs and Indian Institute of Science is doing brilliantly well, the other universities are doing much more in terms of research. And research, by the way, is the key for you to get a good job. What is research? Can anybody tell me? What do you understand by research? Give me a simple, what research? You say, no, I have to do research about it. I don't know where my boyfriend went yesterday. So I'll have to find out first Instagram, Facebook, then location tracker, and then see where he was. What is research? Sorry? Gathering knowledge? Going into depth about something? Solving a problem. Yes, very good. Solving something. Creating knowledge is research. Where, for example, yes? Please. Yes. 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 So, sir, this was from the Indian Express, the newspaper that published a report. No, no. So, we are looking at the average of all engineering colleges in India. All. Yes. 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 So, you know, sir, what happens is, as I said, so now there are a lot of engineering colleges in India which are doing extremely well. Yes. 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 Okay, listen, guys, this is a question for you all also, not just for me. Yes. You know, sir, I'll tell you what happens is, in India, there are more than 5 lakh students who prepare for the IIT's education, right? The percentage... So, 15 lakh students who write the JEE mains, And the number of seats, can you tell me what percentage get into IITs? Yes. 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 Okay. Yes. So, you know, so we talk of majority in a country like India where we are not talking about. Yes. 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 So it depends, sir. Yes. Certainly. Certainly. Yes. Correct. Correct. Yes. So, you know, at our university, so if you let me answer, I'll answer this question. Yes. Please, go ahead. Yes. 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 So, sir, at our university, I can tell about us, there are, again, as you said, a million other universities, and everybody has a different perception about what they can and cannot do. At Krea, I'm saying, even if somebody comes from... Yes. So, let me... So... Yes. 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 So let me tell you this now if I can answer. The point is at Krea, it doesn't matter even if you come from humanities or the arts, you can study pure sciences. Yes. I am talking about Krea. Yes. 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 So let me... So let me answer this. Now I request you to let me answer this. Is that at Krea, it doesn't matter if you come from a non-science background. So let me answer. Let me answer this question. Now, there are two students. I'm taking an example of two of them. Both of them want to study, for example, computer science. Okay? Now, one goes to an engineering college. I studied computer science in my undergrad. You will study programming languages, PHP, SQL, Java, app development, web development, all of that. There's another boy who comes to Krea, for example, studies computer science, as I said, is allowed. Then along with computer science, he says, take psychology. So these are subjective questions that you're answering. How will I be? So for example, let me continue this, that if he takes computer science and psychology, both of them go for an interview which requires, like for example, user experience development, right? So both of them have understood tech. Of course, his tech knowledge might not be as good as his, but he also understands humanities and people. Yes. So, you know, the point is, there are, as I said, there are lakhs of colleges in India which offer another 10 lakh combinations. It's not for everyone. It is for whoever wants to study that. I can speak to you on a one-on-one, for sure. Yeah? I'm sorry for this. But anyways, all his answers were valid, right? Data can be interpreted in whatever form you want to. Yeah, it can go into extremes, where somebody is portraying something which is not so true. For example, one of the things that he pointed out was very right. Doesn't mean all engineering programs are wrong. If I came across like that, that is wrong. You should, so if you're planning to do engineering, look at the curriculum of that university or that school or that engineering college. If it's not updated, then you should not study. or you should not go to that university because you will also become one of those engineers who then get into sales jobs, which is by far the majority of what happens with engineers in India today. And it is the truth. But I'm not talking for everyone. Of course, there are IITs who are doing so well. There are NITs. There is so many other engineering colleges which are much better, right? If you manage to get into them, you should take it. Yeah. But again, you know, we get students who have offers from IIT who've left that to study with Krea. That is their perception. So as I answered to him, these are subjective questions. If tomorrow he comes and tells me, this is what I want to do, no data or no nothing can support what he wants to do, right? That is the truth of life. And like me, 100 other people will come and talk to you about this. You should at the end do what you like doing, right? In research, so when I said research is about knowledge creation, if 10 of you have studied economics, okay, how are all 10 of you different from each other? If all of you have studied the same curriculum, only when you read more or you understand different other topics and you try to solve problems is when you will be different. Why will a JP Morgan or a, which is a good company, consulting company, BCG. Have you heard of BCG? Yeah? Why would a BCG hire you? Only if you have that thought process. Okay? So, whichever course, as I said, you want to do, even if you want to do law, right? Look at the program. What does it entail? Yeah? Whether it's just the traditional knowledge or whether they're trying to change the curriculum to fit the needs of today. That's all I'm saying. Yeah? So, at Krea, we have research centers. So, for example, we have the Center for Writing and Pedagogy. Yeah? Which will have about 10 writing faculty members who will help you with your communication skills. And these are all apart from your academic programs. You will have the Dalai Lama Center for Ethics and Transformative Values. You have the Muhammad Yunus Center for Social Business. If you want to study inclusion and, you know, you want to get into the development sector, you have a media lab. Anybody interested in photography or AR, VR or animation? So the media lab will be headed by somebody called Professor Hariharan, who's a national award-winning filmmaker. So these are people who are available. So even if you're doing biology, you will be able to go to the media lab and get support from them. Okay? Also, most of our programs are immersive learning experiences. So every summer, you're supposed to do an internship. And the university will help you with those. Okay? There is a career services center which will start working with you from day one, trying to understand what you like and where are those jobs that you want to study. Okay, so they will help you with those, some of those. At the university, we also have, so Krea is just a year old, but we've already started partnering with institutions and universities around the world. So one of the partnerships that we have is something called Academic Internship Council, which is in the US. So Krea is actually the only Indian university to have partnered with them. So Krea graduates will be able to do internships in 20 other countries around the world. Yeah, AIC is the one that even gives internships to the Ivy League university, so that coveted. And even in partnerships, we're looking at major vice partners. So for example, anybody wants to study environmental studies, we've partnered with James Cook University because they have the best marine biology program in the world. So we will do these partnerships according to the major that you want to study. So you can study trimesters abroad, you can study for summer programs, you can do research collaborations, all of those are possible. Faculty, so I think this is the most important part, right? Where do the faculty come from? Because the curriculum is good. So we have people from Oxford and Harvard and Cambridge and Imperial and the IITs teaching full time. So this is probably the best set of faculty members that you can get. And again, these are multidisciplinary faculty. To answer to that gentleman's question, we have people. The dean of the school is Professor Bishnu Mahapatra. He is a political scientist from Oxford, but he's also a poet. Right? We have John, who studied, biology from Cambridge, PhD. Again, he's into literature. We have doctors who've studied MBBS, quit their professions, got into environmental studies, went to Cambridge, and now teach environmental studies. So you have all kinds of people. Okay? You have to find a niche for yourself. And don't worry, there are always jobs for everyone. According to me, unemployment, you can't study 15, 20 years and then not get a job. There are a lot of job opportunities. Do whatever you want to study Yeah, and there will be an application for that. Yeah, don't worry about jobs. If you're good, you'll always get a job. Then you have a lot of people who come to the university to talk to you, apart from you know, your academics. So, for example, some of them is Venerable Priyadarshi, who is a faculty at the MIT Institute, and he's the head of the media lab at MIT and the ethics lab. So he came to talk to students about ethics in the age of AI. How do you make ethical decisions when you talk of AI? So amazing people from all walks of life come to talk to you. What can you do after studying at Krea? Well, anything. You can go into the civil services. You can go work for government. You can get into. You can get a full-time job with a corporate. Become an entrepreneur. Depends on what you want to do. The first class of Krea that we got last year. So we, as I said, we are a year old. So last year we had almost 1,200 students who applied to us for 100 seats. So our acceptance rate was around 10%. Yeah. But we are looking for meritorious students. So we don't go by singular parameters. So we don't see whether your academics is 99%. It doesn't matter to us as much. Yeah. So we are looking at a holistic profile. What have you done in academics, extracurriculars, co-curriculars, everything together? How do you think? How do you talk? How aware are you? All of those are important to us. Yeah. In the first batch, we have students from about 40 cities across the country. You know, people from all kinds of socioeconomic backgrounds. You know, we have a good gender mix, 55% girls, 45% boys. And, you know, it's really a diverse class. We're like, we have students from Kashmir and Kathmandu and Dubai and Calcutta and Palakkad in Kerala and all kinds of students. I think this is also very important. Look at the university again that you're planning to go to. What kind of diversity do they have? If they have all students studying from Calcutta, then there is no, you know, like you don't get opinions. You don't get to know the diversity of our rich country. You should have a, because your faculty, you will only spend about 4 to 5 hours in a day. But with your classmates, you will spend about 10 to 15 hours. You want to be with someone from whom you can learn, right? So look at diversity. We have more than 20 clubs on campus. So after classes, you have options of engaging in any of these clubs. Or activities. This is where we are. So we're located, by the way, we're located very close to Chennai, but in Andhra Pradesh. So technically we are in Andhra. We have a 40-acre campus located inside of a place called Sri City. Okay. This is about 60 kilometers north of Chennai, but it's a completely residential campus. So this is the main academic building. We have all the facilities on the campus. So the library, for example, now has about 50,000 books. And we have collaborations with universities. So, for example, one of them is Indian Institute of Science, where through which you have an access to another million books and research papers and all of those available. The campus has sports facilities, almost all of them outdoor, indoor. It has student lounges, cafeterias, gymnasiums. All of those are available on the campus. So there is a lot for you to do outside of your academic interest. All of these are again available. It's a very good green campus. About 30% of it is built. Everything else is green. So especially during the rains, after monsoons, it's very, very beautiful. The final part of the presentation, how do we actually select students, right? This is very important. So, you know, at Krea, we, as I said, we don't look at singular parameters to select or reject you. Like, for example, if you get a 99% in class 12, doesn't mean you're automatically selected. Or if you get an 85, doesn't mean you're rejected. Okay, so we're looking at average on a lot of things. So if all of you in the grade 12, if you're planning to apply, the first stage of application is an online application form which you need to fill. This is very similar to when you apply, especially abroad, but even in some of the Indian universities, where you have to fill a long, comprehensive form. This form will ask for 5 things. First is your academic score, so 9th onwards, 9th, 10th, 11th, and 12th. So 12th, it's good if you can give us a predicted score from the school. Okay, I'm sure the school gives you a predicted score, right? So put that in the application form. Then we are looking for co-curriculars. What are co-curriculars? How is it different from extracurriculars? So co-curriculars is anything to do with your academic interests. yeah, to augment your academics. So if you like economics, what have you done about it? So participation in Olympiads, doing an online course or an offline course or a summer school, all of that will help. Research papers, again. So if you've done any project in class where you feel you've given your individual input and it's documented well, any project in class can form as a project, which you can upload in the application form. Then we look for extracurricular. So sports, music, performing arts, theater, social work, community outreach, internships, you know, participation in the student clubs, activities, all of that will add. If you're a school prefect, if you were, you know, like any head of any council, so all of that will add to your CV. Okay. Then you also have to write a personal story, which is an essay. This is again a 500-word essay that you need to write for the application, where you write about yourself. Okay. So there are tips available everywhere for you. Then the fifth thing is SAT or ACT scores. So it's not mandatory, but if you have given SATs, you can put that score. Anybody has taken SAT here? Do many of you do? Okay. Okay. So if so, you have taken. So all the 11th graders, if you're planning, SAT is a good test to take. There are almost 30 Indian universities that now consider SAT scores. Okay, it's not just a test that you take to go to the US anymore. Okay, so you put all of that. If you're shortlisted, we call you for the second stage, which is called an immersion day, which will happen in Calcutta. So this immersion day, we are looking at how you think, basically. So there's case studies, group discussions, interview, there's a presentation, there's an on-the-spot essay. So all of that will happen in the second stage. And we will let you know whether you're shortlisted or not. This is the deadlines, timelines for this year. So we start the this application already started on the 1st of November. The first round will get over on the 22nd of December. So it's highly advised that you apply on the in the first round, which is by the 22nd of December. If you apply by the 22nd, then by the 6th of January, we will let you know whether you're shortlisted or not. Yeah. And the immersion will happen sometime in January, which is still easier for you to give than the second round, for which the immersions will happen in March, which is when your board exams will happen. The third round will be very late. Yeah. So consider, if you're planning to apply, consider the first round. The final part, the fees, how much does it cost? So the fees per year is around 8 lakhs, including living expenses, yeah, living, food, everything, tuition. But as I said, so if you apply to us, and if you've got a confirmed offer, and if you can't afford the fees, then we have aid available. So we've even 100% aid. Like in many cases, living, food, everything is paid for. But you have to prove that you can't afford the fees. So we look at family income, we look at assets, we look at everything. And we should be convinced that you can't afford the fees. Then we have aid available. So apply. Yeah, you never know. You definitely can get selected. So this year, we have 150 seats available. And we are expecting about 2,000 applications from across. Okay, last year, we have three students from Calcutta. One who was a NIOS student, homeschooled, one student from Heritage, and one from La Martinia for boys. Okay, we did not have any applications from this school, but hopefully this year some of you will consider. Okay, any questions? Anyway, so you can always get back to us later. This is my contact details. You can reach to me. Also, what I will do is give you a feedback form. Right? Fill that form. If you want to know anything more from the university, anything at all, just fill in the comment section and we will get back to you. Okay?